Gamal Abdul Nasser was born in 1918, the son of an upper Egyptian postal worker. The future president was obsessed with politics at a young age, but rejected wafdism and socialism, seeking a political ideology that fitted Arab culture and aspirations. Nasser read widely, finding inspiration from both Egyptian reformers and Western classical writers. Early 20th century Egypt was emerging from Ottoman rule and undergoing political and economic transformation. The British moved into the power vacuum left by the Turkish withdrawal, an engineered Egyptian revolution enthroning a British-backed monarch. But many Egyptians wanted to see an end to colonial interference. Both the nationalist Waf Party and the Muslim Brotherhood agitated for reform. When World War II broke out, the British stationed troops in Egypt, and the movement for change grew stronger. Nasser's intelligence and charisma saw him rise swiftly through military ranks, and he was a key player in the 1952 military coup that overthrew King Farouk. It took 2 years of spiteful power struggles and constitutional reform before Nasser was finally elected president of Egypt at only 36 years of age. Egypt's ongoing antagonism with the newly created State of Israel and Nasser's willingness to deal with the Soviets alarmed Western powers, who withdrew funding commitments for Egypt's Aswan Dam hydroelectric project. In 1956, Nasser announced the nationalization of the Suez Canal, one of the world's most important shipping routes, provoking Britain, France, and Israel to hatch a plot to take the Suez back by force. Israel invaded the Sinai, while French parachutists and British commandos attacked Port Said and other strategic targets. The assaults were effective, but the United States became fearful of a disturbance to the delicate Cold War balance of power and forced Britain and France to withdraw. The Arab world saw this as a huge victory for Egypt, and Nasser was feted as a conquering hero. The Soviet Union cemented its relationship with Egypt by pouring funds into the Aswan Dam and other modernizing projects. Nasser became focused on a socialist solution to land reform. He was also determined to wean Egypt off its dependence on Western economies. Above all, Nasser was seen by people across the Middle East as a new breed of Arab, someone who stood up for Arab rights in the face of colonial imperialism. There was a new sense of pride in Arab history and culture. Pan-Arabism spread throughout the continent and influenced many political leaders. In 1960, Nasser came to New York for the United Nations General Assembly and was filmed with communist leaders Khrushchev, Tito, and Castro. Nasser had caused consternation in the West by announcing Egypt's neutrality in the Cold War. He was a foundation member of the non-aligned group of nations, together with Yugoslavia's Tito and India's Nehru. Although Western observers considered Nasser suspiciously close to the communist powers, he was critical of Arab communists, denouncing them for being overly influenced by outside interests. In his opinion, neither Western capitalism nor Eastern communism was the way forward for the Arab world. Nasser moved Egypt towards a socialist economic system and instituted huge land, education, and health reforms. In 1962, he hosted a triumphant celebration for Algerian leader Ahmed Ben Bella, whose Egyptian-backed National Liberation Front had won an 8-year struggle for independence against the French. Nasser's position as the father of Arab nationalism seemed unassailable, and the Arab world looked to him for leadership.
Three, two, one.